So this is my post-fight review of Dillian White versus Robert Hellenius. I'm recording this immediately after the final bell, so recording it before the scorecards come in. I'm presuming Dillian White is going to win a clear decision. I'm thinking something like 10 rounds to 2, something of that nature. It's not going to be close scorecards, so I thought we'd get straight on and record a video. When this fight was announced, I did an initial thoughts video which said that this was going to be a potentially intriguing fight. And it started out like an intriguing fight. Certainly, after two rounds, I was on the edge of my seat thinking that this was a fight that would go either way. Unfortunately, from rounds three onwards, it was a disappointing fight. And the action slowly petered out to what essentially became a relatively disappointing and drab affair, if I'm frank. The first round, kind of a nothing round, both guys feeling each other out. The second round, a big Robert Hellenius round. Hellenius repeatedly leading an oncoming Dillian White onto a straight right hand. Hellenius timing Dillian White nicely, catching him with big power punches on several very notable occasions in the second round. And Dillian White starting to look like a fighter who was getting caught with some regularity. I don't want to say he was hurt, because he took the punches well. But there were a few times he was notably stopped in his tracks, let's put it that way. The third round onwards, Dillian White started to come on strong. Rounds three and rounds four, Dillian White was putting punches together quite nicely, landing hard punches to Hellenius, especially to the body, also some to the head. From about fourth round onwards, Robert Hellenius really goes into sparring partner mode. He's trying to survive, he's fighting on the back foot, he's looking to keep a high guard and take punches against the ropes. And the ambition is completely sucked away from Robert Hellenius. For me personally, rounds 3 to rounds 12 is pretty much all Dillian White. Dillian White is coming forward, Hellenius' output has dropped completely, and Hellenius seems to be fighting a fight looking to survive as opposed to a fight where he was looking to win. White completely dominant in that period, and as I say, I wouldn't be surprised if the scorecards are 11-1, 10-2, 9-3, but I'm presuming it's going to be wide in favour of Dillian White. The Sky commentators, I really thought they had a particularly bad night when it came to this fight. When Robert Hellenius was doing well in the first couple of rounds, I heard Adam Smith comparing Robert Hellenius to Tyson Fury when he fought Vladimir Klitschko. A few rounds after that comment, where he was comparing Robert Hellenius to a peak Tyson Fury, Smith changed tact and started saying he wondered if, aged 33, Robert Hellenius was simply too old for the elite of the heavyweight division. A particularly poor affair, in my opinion, in terms of the Sky commentary, but we'll probably record another video tomorrow with some other criticism from myself about the way this Sky card's been put together tonight, because it's been bizarre from start to finish. Dillian White, for example, didn't even get a ring walk, which, as long-time Dillian White fans will know, is one of the highlights of what's in Dillian White fight. So that was disappointing. As I say, I don't want to digress too much in this video. We'll probably cover that separately from tomorrow onwards. But yeah, Sky, the commentators, they really didn't seem to know what was wrong with Robert Hellenius. They kept speculating about a potential injury, about how he kept shaking his right hand. They kept speculating that maybe he'd spent too many rounds sparring the elite opponents. They kept speculating that he was too old. They seemed to have completely forgotten that the fight was made at 2 weeks' notice. You know, that seemed to completely go over their heads. You know, was he too old? Had he done too many rounds as a sparring partner? Has he got a hand injury? To be honest, you're dealing with a guy who's best part of 18 stone, who's 6'6", 6'7", 6'8", who's coming to the fight on 2 weeks' notice. And the last week, let's be honest, flying, press conferences, weigh-ins, public workouts, we're dealing with a guy who's had 1 week specific training. Now, I know he was a professional boxer. I know he's supposed to be ready and keep himself in good shape. But for me, the theme of this fight is more what could have been. The Robert Hellenius who fought in the first two or three rounds is a Robert Hellenius who, for me, could have beaten Dillian White if he'd shown up in prime condition. You know, but simply, Hellenius had very, very little in the tank. When the gas tank emptied, it emptied very, very quickly, and White was left to dominate. From White's perspective, the biggest win of his career, credit goes to him for that. He showed a good engine. He came on, he threw a lot of punches and came forward for 12 rounds. And White is showing that he is a guy on the peripheries of the world top 10. You know, he's beaten Derek Chisora, he's beaten Robert Hellenius. These are respectable names, don't get me wrong. But there's still a lot I see in White which make me think he will come up short again if he fights at the elite level. He's quite Chisora-esque sometimes. The construction of his punches is still very unrefined. You see him sort of flailing out with a jab rather than throwing it properly and committing to it. He swings quite wildly. Numerous times in this fight, you see him loading up, throwing a huge haymaker hook and almost knocking himself off balance. The amount of times he throws a hook and almost turns himself around with it. He's got the Derek Chisora style wind up overhand from the back of the hall. You know, he's not someone who gets his punches constructed perfectly. He's not someone who maximizes speed and efficiency by punching in a straight line hard and fast. He's a bit wild, a bit looping. Defensively, very open. Just look how Robert Hellenius able to time him, lead him on to big, big punches in the latter round, in the earlier rounds, should I say. So for me, still a lot to work on for Dillian White, and he was still made to miss wildly in the middle to late rounds despite his opponent's fatigue. I also thought whilst he was being dominant, I'd like to have seen him mix it up a bit more. Don't get me wrong, White pretty much swept the middle to late rounds in this fight, but he was getting frustrated. He was doing the same thing and it was kind of failing to break Robert Hellenius down and get Robert Hellenius out of there. I'd have liked to see White do something a bit different. Perhaps try and cut the ring down a bit more. You know, he was walking Hellenius down, but Hellenius was free whenever he wanted to wheel out, get a bit more space and get on his bike again. I'd have liked to have seen Dillian White try and do something different and commit to more of an inside game. He was kind of fighting at long range, fighting at mid range, closing down the range. But then when they got to more like the inside area, Hellenius was just able to pivot out. You know, I'd have liked to see White maybe drop a shoulder to kind of pin Hellenius against the ropes and then try and work the body with combinations. You know, I'd have liked to have seen a little bit more variety because he kind of looked, despite the fact he was winning the rounds comfortably, and I give him credit for that, he kind of looked slightly out of ideas in terms of how to get a different result. As for Robert Hellenius, a frustrating performance from his fans. So did he still got something to offer. So did he had some class, a lot of durability, a lot of heart. But not enough to win many rounds in this fight, unfortunately. Is he worth one more chance with 6 to 8 weeks preparation? Possibly so. But Hellenius has been a plodding fighter for some time now. He's a fighter whose stamina seems to empty. He's not a high output fighter. And, we've seen that cost him now on several occasions throughout his career. So is Hellenius worth one more chance? Yeah, potentially. He's not one to write off just yet. But he's coming up short and he needs something to be done differently. This is one of the very few fights that I'm actually completely happy with my pre-fight prediction on. I made a big point of not making a prediction on this fight till after the weigh-in. And I actually had a very close look at Hellenius in the public workout and at the weigh-in before committing to one side or the other. My prediction was that White would win by UD. I said Hellenius was tougher than people thought. I said White's power may be ever so slightly overrated. And I said that Hellenius would make White look thoroughly average in spots, but that White would power on and his youth, his momentum, would mean that he'd establish a lead in the second half of the fight and go on to win a UD. So I'm happy with my prediction in the fight, but this is precisely why I wanted to wait and see how Hellenius looked in the lead up to fight week before committing to a side. Because Hellenius weighed in 10 pounds heavier than his last fight, which was against Evgeny Orlov, a sort of mid-level journeyman type, if you like. So if he's able to weigh in at that level for a journeyman type fight, he should be able to weigh in at the same or less for a much bigger fight against a much more dangerous opponent in Dillian White. But he didn't do that, which for me told me that he hadn't had the preparation he needed. I also thought he looked quite plodding, quite slow, quite robotic in the public workout, which again was a theme of tonight, unfortunately. So disappointing fight for me. Could have been intriguing, started intriguing. Who knows if the result could have been different if Hellenius had trained 8 weeks specifically for Dillian White. Credit does go to Dillian White. You know, he showed a lot of things in there. He has improved as a fighter, and this is the biggest win of his career as far as I'm concerned. It's a similar level win to the Derek Chisora win. But for me, with Dillian White, some doubts persist with whether he will be able to bridge that gap between top 10 and elite. Yeah, is he too easy to catch? Is he too easy to time? Is he too defensively open? And does he make life too easy for his opponent by persisting to swing wildly and miss and leave himself exposed? An entertaining guy inside the ring, an entertaining guy outside of the ring, A tough night for Dillian White if he were to rematch Joshua or take on one of the other champions, Wilder and Parker, in my humble opinion. Let me know your thoughts on this fight, guys. Leave your comments in the section below. If you're new, please do subscribe so you can check out all of my other stuff, including my Anthony Joshua post-fight review that will be coming later. Please hit the thumbs up to support this video. Many thanks for tuning in.